Hello home students, in our earlier class we discussed some of the problems, that is applications of linear equations in one variable. The same exercise, same models we are going to discuss in this class also. Here we are extending the same problems basing on geometrical figures and number theory in all these things. Here today we are going to discuss about whatever we discussed in our previous class, it's a continuation, the extension part only we are discussing in this class. In that here we have one problem, that it is three consecutive integers add up to 51. What are these integers? Three consecutive integers. In our previous class also we discussed some problems basing on the numbers, the same only. Difference between two numbers is 15, and by adding the two numbers we will get 95. One problem we discussed and we solved by using linear equation in one variable. And one more problem, two numbers are in the ratio 5:3. What are the two numbers? The difference is 18. What are the two numbers we discussed by with this given data, framing by framing a linear equation and then by solving it, we discussed previous problems. In the same way here also we have one problem, it is three consecutive integers. What is mean by three consecutive? Consecutive meaning the numbers which are coming in an order, that it is either in ascending or descending, or either positive or negative numbers. The three consecutive integers meaning 1, 2, 3 or 3, 4, 5. In the same way negative numbers also, what are the three numbers they asked you? That it is, one more condition they have given, that it is by adding that three numbers we will get the result as 51. So with that number only we are going to discuss the this problem, that it is integers they said okay, and consecutive integers they said okay. From this data we are going to frame a linear equation. How you will get that three numbers? For example, by taking numericals only, I'll explain you. Here I am taking three integers, 3, 4, 5. Okay, just for example purpose I am telling you the known values, very well known values I am taking here. See, assume the first one as x. By adding 1, that it is 3 plus 1, you will get the next number or not? Yes, you will get the next number, that it is the consecutive number of 3 is 4. So here the same I am taking x plus 1. X means 3 I have taken. X plus 1. By adding 1 you will get the next value, that it is its consecutive value you will get. And by how much you will what number you will get the next number? By adding 3, by adding which number you will get 5? That it is plus 2, that is 3 plus 2. Okay, 3 plus 2. In the same way here I assumed that x as 3. To get its next number it becomes x plus 1. After that after the next one you will get by adding plus 2, that it is 3 plus 2 you have you got 3 plus 2 as 5. In the same way here also x plus 2, you will get its next consecutive number. Okay, now what are the three consecutive numbers? X, x plus 1, x plus 2. Understood? In general, they asked you to get three consecutive integers. What is the condition? By adding that 3, you have to get their sum as 51. Do you know which number you will take that 3? Which set of numbers you will take? So, we are going to assume a variable that it is x as the first number. And its consecutive becomes x plus 1. After next consecutive number, x plus 2. Okay. So, now we are taking the first number as x. This is just for your understanding purpose I have taken here. Okay. Just three numbers I have taken. 3, 4, 5. 3, 4, 5. So, first 3. I assumed instead of 3, I have taken x. How you will get 4? By adding plus 1. So, the next number becomes x plus 1. After that, after the next number, how you will get? It is x plus 2. Okay. So, assume that here I am taking the first number as x. Letting the first number be x. Let the required first number be x. Okay. And the next two consecutive numbers becomes. Therefore, the three consecutive numbers are x, x plus 1 and x plus 2. Okay. What is the condition they have given? Three consecutive integers add up to 51. Sum of the three consecutive integers is equal to first number plus second number plus third number. Okay, these are the three numbers. Now, here we have an expression. Okay, here in this expression you have these three or like terms. By adding that three like terms, you will get x plus x plus x. It is 3x. Okay. Next, the constants are 1 and 2. 1 plus 2, as you know, it is 3. Okay. This is whatever we assume. By adding that 3, what you will get? That result you got here. Now, given, according to the given problem, sum of three integers, three consecutive integers, is equal to 51. Here, 3x plus 3. And here 51. Now finally we came to a linear equation in one variable, that is 3x is equal to, now the simplification of this linear equation. 3x plus 3 is equal to 51. Take this plus 3 to this side, it becomes minus 3. 3x is equal to 51 minus 3, it is 48. X is equal to, here 3x meaning is 3 into x. It becomes that side division. As you know, by transposition, this side it is multiplication, it becomes that side division. 3 ones 3 16, x is equal to 16. Okay, so the first number is 16. Required, first number is 16. Second number is 16 plus 1, it is 17. And third number is 16 plus 2, 18. Why I have taken 16 plus 1, 16 plus 2? Because we assumed that the first number as x, second number as x plus 1, and the third number is x plus 2. These are the three consecutive numbers. Just for verification purpose, I am taking you here. See that. By adding these three, that is 16 plus 17 plus 18. 6 plus 7, 13 plus 8, 21. 2 plus 1, 3, 4, 5. So they sum 51. They have given the same as 51. Okay. It is x plus 1, x plus 2 I have taken. If possible, you can take x minus 1, x plus 1 also. Okay. So, this is, in this problem, they gave you the sum of 3 consecutive multiples of 8 is 888. Find the multiples. Same as it is before problem. But only difference is here, the given 3 consecutive the 3 numbers are the multiples of 8. That is the difference. In the before problem, they have given 3 consecutive integers. This, in this problem, that 3 numbers are multiples of 8 and they are consecutive. Okay, meaning if one number is 16, the other number becomes 24 and the next number becomes 32. Likewise, here that is the condition. So, as we did in the before problem, in the same way, here also we are going to assume first the 3 numbers are x, plus 1, x plus 2. And they said multiples of 8. So that by multiplying 8, you will get the 3 numbers. Okay. Assume that three consecutive multiples of 8 are, what I said, first one is x, second one is x plus 1, and the third one is x plus 2, but they said they are multiples of 8. So that 8 into x plus 1, 8 into x plus 2. Okay. Now, the 3 multiples are the three multiples are 8 into x, 8x, 8 into x plus 1 meaning 8x plus 8, 8x plus 8, 8 into x, 8x, 8 into 2, 16. These are the three multiples of 18. Sorry, 8. Now, the sum of three given numbers is equal to 8x plus 8x plus 8 plus 8x plus 16. Now these three are the multiples of 8. 8x plus 8x plus 8x, it is 24x. 8 plus 16, it is also 24. This is their sum. According to the given problem, their sum is equal to 888. Now, this is their sum and this is also their sum. It is 24x plus 24 is equal to 888. Here we have a linear equation in one variable. Okay. Now, take these constants to one side of the equation, or else in these two (coughs) 24, 24, both common. By taking it, 24 into x plus 1 is equal to 888. 24 into, I said, so that it becomes division this side. 888 by 24. X plus 1 is equal to 24 ones. X is equal to 36. Now, the first number is equal to 8 into 36. 8 6 are 48, 8 3 is 24, plus 4 28, 288. Second number is equal to 8 into x plus 1, that is 8 into 37. 296. Third number equal to 8 into x plus 2, it is 36 plus 2, 38. 304. Okay, these are the three numbers, multiples of 8, as well as by adding the three, we will get it is 888. I am going to check that result. 288 plus 296 plus 304. 8 plus 6 14, 14 plus 4 18, 9 9 18, 3 2 plus 2 5 plus 3 8. So they sum 888. The same they have given in the question also. So here the three numbers are 288, 296, 304. It is very simple, same as it is the before one. That in the before one we have taken the three integers x, x plus 1, x plus 2. Just only one condition they have given, that 3 are the multiples of 8. Multiples means we will multiply the 3 by 8. That is 8 into x, 8 into x plus 1, 8 into x plus 2. So by adding that you will get 24x plus 24. As per the given problem it is 888. 24x plus 24 equal to 888. Now in these two we have 24 as common. By taking 24 as common it is x plus 1. So it is 24 into x plus 1. It becomes that side division. It is 24 ones, 24 37s. X plus 1 is 37, x equal to 37 minus 1, 36. So the first number is 288, second number is 296, third number is 304. Okay. Here in this problem, they have given three consecutive integers are such that when they are taken in increasing order and multiplied by 2, 3 and 4. Respectively, they add up to 74. Find these numbers. Okay, so here one more, as we discussed in the first problem, three consecutive integers. As I have taken that three consecutive integers as x, x plus 1, x plus 2. In the increasing order itself, I have taken. And I said at the same time, we will take these three numbers as x minus 1, x, x plus 1. Like that also we will take. In the same way, in negative values also we will take. But in the before problem, they didn't give you any condition. Either in increasing or decreasing, whatever it may be, any anything they have, any condition they have given. But here in this problem they are said that three consecutive integers must be in ascending order only, sorry, increasing order only. So that increasing order means here these two are increasing only. First minus 1, by adding plus 1 you will get x, by adding plus 1 you will get x plus 1. Like that x before 1 also x, x plus 1, x plus 2. So both we have both are in ascending order, sorry, increasing order only. And they said multiplied by 2, 3 and 4 respectively. Okay, so and their sum is 74 they said. Now take that let assume that the three consecutive integers be x, x plus 1, x plus 2 and whatever they have given in increasing order, they are in increasing order only. and they said multiplied by 2, 3 and 4. Given condition is 2 into x plus 3 into x plus 1 plus 4 into x plus 2 is equal to 74. Okay? Multiplied by 2. First number is by 2. Second number is by 3. Third number is by 4. And the sum is 74, they said. Now, 2 into x, 2x. 3 into x, it is 3x. 3 into 1, 3. 4 into x, 4x. 4 into 2, 8. Is equal to 74. Okay, now 2x, 3x, 4x are the three like terms. So by adding 2 plus 3, it is 5. 5 plus 4, it is 9. 9x plus 3 plus 8 is 11 is equal to 74. 9x is equal to 74. This plus 11 becomes this side. Minus 11. 9x is equal to 4 minus 1, 3, 7 minus 1, 6. X equal to 9x, meaning is 9 into x. It becomes division. That is 63 by 9. 9 ones, 9 sevens. X is equal to 7. Now, required 3 numbers are 2 into x, 2 into 7, 14, 3 into x plus 1, it is 3 into 7 plus 1, 3 into 8, it is 24, 4 into x plus 2, that is 4 into 7 plus 2, 9, 4 nines are 36. These are the 3 numbers they said. First one is 14, second one is 24, third one is 36. Shall we check? 14, 24, 36. 8 plus 6, 14. 2 plus 2, 4 plus 3, 7. 74 we got. Here also they have given 74 only. Here in this problem, this is about ages. As I discussed in the before itself in the introduction part of this chapter, this exercise also, I said in ages also we will discuss, we use these linear equations that we are going to apply now. The ages of Rahul and Harun are in the ratio 5 is to 7. 4 years later, the sum of their ages will be 56 years. What are their present ages? Here, two boys are there and their ages ratio is 5 is to 7. 4 years later, meaning from hereafter 4 years means we should add, we have to take that as plus 4. Meaning, now your present age is, some of you are in 12 years and some of you are in 13 years and some of you are in maybe 14. That it is a rare case. You people are either 12 or 13. So many of you are in the age of, at the age of 12 and 13 only. 4 years later, your ages becomes by adding 12 plus 4. That means 4 years after that you your age is 16. If it is present 12, your age after 4 years your age is 16. Now if it is 13, after 4 years your age becomes 17. How did you get that? By adding plus 4. In the same way, here also we are going to add plus 4 to your to their present ages. So did they give you any present age? No, just present ages ratio they have given. So by assuming that ratio as what is the ratio of their present ages? It is 5:7. And after 4 years, now their present age becomes, ratio of their present age is 5x:7. And 4 years later means it becomes 5x+4, 7x+4. Why? Because I have explained you now. Your present age 13 means 4 years means 13+4. In the same way, they are in present age 5x, 7x. 4 years after means 5x+4, 7x+4. Okay. So first, assume that their present ages ratio be 5x:7x. Okay. Let the ratio of present ages of Rahul and Harun be 5x:7x. Okay. 4 years later, the ratio of their ages is equal to, now 5x 7x. 4 years means 5x+4 7x+4. 4 years later the sum of their ages will be given. After 4 years, sum of their ages is equal to 5x+4 plus 7x+4. Here 5x and 7x like terms. By adding you will get 12x. 4 plus 4, 8. Okay. Now, according to the given problem, after 4 years, sum of their ages is equal to 56. These two are equal. Now 12x plus 8 is equal to 56. Finally, we came to a linear equation in one variable. Now take this plus 8 to this side. It becomes 12x is equal to 56 minus 8. 12x is equal to 48. 12x meaning is 12 into it becomes division 12 ones 12 fours. Now x is equal to 4. X is equal to 4. So their present ages, their present ages 5 into 4 and 7 into 4, it is 20 and 28. Okay. Now we are going to check after 4 years their ages. So present 20, after 4 means plus 4. Present 28, after 4 means 28 plus 4. 24 plus 32, it is 56. Whatever they have given, same we get. Okay, these are the today's class. Listen, watch carefully, do the practice the same problems without seeing. Okay, do on your own. How to, then you will get how to frame a linear equation and how to solve these things. Read out the question twice or thrice carefully and then go through the problem. Meaning, first give importance to frame a linear equation and then easily you can solve the problem. Hari Om. Thank you.